Now, do you believe Australia has a class system? Well, if you think that there's just upper, middle and lower, guess what? Thankfully, there's the Australian National University, because they have told us there's not just one, there's not just two, there's not just three, there's not just four, there's six different classes. Which one do you think that you actually fall into here, right? Have a look here. The different ones here in the precariat, there we go, is the lowest one. Because these are the people with the lowest household income. Many are unemployed, claiming government aid, otherwise known as welfare. Their social and cultural capital scores are the lowest. Then, the second lowest rung on the ladder is an ageing worker. A large proportion of this class are pensioned retirees, at least likely, along with the previous group, to be engaged in gainful employment, the least likely, rather. Then, about the middle of the road, is the new worker, which you can see there is, in contrast, almost half of all new workers whose mean age is naturally younger and employed full-time. They have more financial success and have better social and cultural capital. Then we get into the most evil class of all, the established middle. These are the true evil people. These are the people they want to go up because they are more entrenched and comfortable, the two worst words you can throw around. Remember when relaxed and comfortable was what we wanted 20 years ago? Now, we're beginning to get bad here. Then we get up to the emerging affluent. Well, the emerging affluent class reports higher income levels than the established middle, but interestingly, lower wealth accumulation. So they spend a lot of money if they get their money. And finally, the established affluent, which is the closest Australia has to an aristocracy. So new money, old money and all the rest of it, but how dare you be established middle. Does your brain hurt slightly, Ben, now that upper, middle and lower has now been changed into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6?
I'm absolutely screwed. I've got no idea where I fit here. I thought I was one and then I turned into another. It is, and again, I was reading that as you were reading that as well, just to try and get my head around it. I've gone over these notes probably about 3 or 4 times. I'm completely lost. Yeah. I have no idea. I thought I knew where I fit into the world, into this country. No.
But I thought
there's nothing new about this. This is demographers, Bernard Salt, market researchers, they divide the population up in various ways, in income and age brackets and where they live and all that sort of stuff, and then say, OK, they fit into these various categories. I have to say, this particular study is a bit of a lightweight. They did 1,200, they had a sample size of 1,200, and they came up with 6 groups, so that's 200 average per group.
Yeah.
You know, they're drawing a pretty long bow there.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, but the other thing is that the assumption is that classes are bad, and you think about, you know, workers, working class, middle class, upper class in the English sense. And the thing about those classes is that you couldn't move between them. Once you were working class, didn't matter whether you were really rich or not, you're still working class. That doesn't apply to, even if these classes exist, and I think there's a fair amount of BS there, but if they did exist, there's nothing to stop you moving between the classes in Australia. That's the distinction.
Well, absolutely correct. And look, that's the point. You can be born into the poorest house and end up with the best one in the best part of town. You mightn't get to established affluent. I don't know if you have to have multiple generations there or not, but we'll see. But Caroline, also, I thought we were living in the age where we weren't supposed to be putting people in brackets. We weren't supposed to be, there's 52 separate genders you can pick if you'd like on Facebook.
What if I identify as being in a different class?
Yes.
Does that make me part of
So you could be cashed up,
yes,
but say, you know, I identify as an ageing worker.
Yes, exactly.
Yes. I don't think anyone would say that of itself, but yes, it's a good point.
It might be racist for anyone to say, no, you can't.
Well, exactly. That's so offensive. How can you suggest that, Senator? It's
certainly offensive.
Yeah, dearly offensive. Dearly offensive. All right, Ken, I know what you think about that or anything else.